Cleaning your home can sometimes lead to surprises. You may find some forgotten change in the sofa, or discover that your kitchen counter actually looks nice when it's not full of food. However, one of the biggest mysteries during the cleaning process involves our humble ceiling fans. Ew. Millions of us become confused by the thick layer of dust settled on top of the blades. It seems perplexing how a regularly used ceiling fan manages to accumulate such a thick layer of dust. One would naturally presume that the movement of the fan blades would send dust flying back into the room. To understand this peculiar occurrence, we must inspect the composition of dust, along with a few fundamentals of electromagnetism and fluid dynamics. Like it or not, the bulk of the dust in your home is made from dead human skin and hair cells. Our bodies, which constantly replenish skin cells, shed thousands of these cells every day. This contributes to a large number of tiny dust particles suspended in the air, circulating within our homes at all times. If you're a pet owner, this issue is multiplied even further. Although a small fraction of dust consists of microscopic particles discharged by dust mites who feed on our shed skin and hair cells, the central source is our own bodies. Focusing on plastic ceiling fans, the common recipients of the dust we mentioned, it's imperative to acknowledge electricity's role in the relationship of dust molecules and fan blades. The dust particles floating around your house possess a sort of electric charge, leading to a tendency for these molecules to pull together, giving birth to those dust bunnies hiding beneath your bed. Additionally, fan blades whiz through the air, grazing against air molecules and displacing them. This action leads to a buildup of charge on the fan blade's leading edge, creating static electricity. As dust molecules encounter this charged edge while drifting through the air, they are drawn to it and subsequently attach. Due to friction, the fan blade's leading edge harbors the most charge, thus attracting the most dust. Combine this with the stickiness of dust particles, and that considerable layer of dust on fan blades begins to make more sense. However, this theory only provides an explanation for the dust on plastic ceiling fans. Understanding why all types of fans become dust magnets, no matter their material, requires another field of science: fluid dynamics. While static electricity accumulation applies to plastic fans, this doesn't occur for metal fans, though dust noticeably collects on their leading edges. Fluid dynamics is the study of the motion of liquids and gases. Applying it to a ceiling fan scenario, the airspeed at the fan blade's surface is zero. As you move away from the fan blade surface, the air's speed and movement increases. However, the precise area where dust settles on the fan, the surface, has little air movement. Minute entities like dust particles get pressed against the surface and then stay there, more so on the leading edge of the blade, guarded by a thin layer of inactive air just above the surface. Over time, as dust piles up, it becomes the new surface, and a substantial amount of dust is able to accumulate. The fan blade's speed doesn't alter this fluid dynamics law. A faster-moving fan will collect dust faster because the blades will interact with more dust particles. Depending on the material of the ceiling fan in your room, dust collection can be attributed to different natural forces. Nonetheless, all ceiling fans are destined to be dust magnets thanks to fluid dynamics or static electricity, regardless of the speed at which they spin.